In this video, we'll study about the arterioles, capillaries, and sinusoids. First, we'll study about the arterioles. When traced distally, the muscular artery, they progressively decrease in caliber till they have a diameter of about 100 micrometer. They then become continuous with arteriole. The larger or the muscular arteriole are 100 to 50 micrometer in diameter. The arteriole less than 50 micrometer diameter are called terminal arteriole. All the three layers, the tunica intima, the tunica media, and the tunica adventitia, are thin as compared to the arteries. In arteriole, the adventitia is made up of a thin network of collagen fibers. The arterioles are the main regulator of the peripheral vascular resistance, contraction, and the relaxation of the smooth muscle present in the wall of the arteriole can alter the peripheral vascular resistance or the blood pressure and the blood flow. So here you can see these are the histological pictures which shows the arteriole. So the tunica intima, the tunica media, and the tunica adventitia are very thin when compared to the elastic and the muscular artery. So there are two types of arterioles. One is the muscular arteriole, the other one is the terminal arteriole. The muscular arteriole can be distinguished from the true arteries by their small diameter, and they do not have internal elastic lamina, and they have a few layers of smooth muscle in their media. So the muscular arteriole are smaller in diameter, and they do not have internal elastic lamina, and they have a few layers of smooth muscle in their media. Whereas the terminal arteriole can be distinguished from the muscular arteriole by they have a diameter less than 50 micrometer. The smallest terminal arteriole has a diameter as small as 12 micrometer. They only have a thin layer of muscle in their walls, and they give off lateral branches which are called as meta-arterioles to the capillary bed. So this is a diagrammatic picture. Here you can see this is the arteriole which becomes the terminal arteriole, and it gives off the lateral branches which are known as the meta-arterioles to the capillary bed. The initial segment of lateral branches or the meta-arterioles is surrounded by few muscle fibers, and these muscle cells constitutes the pre-capillary sphincter, and this sphincter regulates the flow of blood to the capillaries. Next we'll see about the capillaries. The terminal arterioles are continuous into a capillary plexus that pervades the tissue supply. The capillaries are the smallest blood vessels. The average diameter of a capillary is about 8 micrometer. Exchange of oxygen, carbon dioxide, fluids, and various molecules between the blood and the tissue takes place through the walls of the capillary plexus and through the post-capillary venules. The arrangement of the capillary plexus and its density varies from tissue to tissue. The density being greatest in the tissues having high metabolic activities. When you see the structure of the capillary, the wall of a capillary is formed essentially by the endothelial cells. So this is a diagrammatic picture. Here you can see the wall is made up of endothelial cells that are lined on the outside by the basal lamina, that is glycoprotein. Overlying the basal lamina, there may be isolated branching perivascular cells which are known as the pericytes. And you have a delicate network of reticular fibers and the cells. The pericyte or the adventitial cell contain contractile filaments in the cytoplasm, and can transform into other cells. There are two types of capillary. One is continuous capillary. The other one is the fenestrated capillary. In the continuous capillary, the edges of the endothelial cells fuse completely with those of the adjoining cells to form a continuous wall. So this is a diagrammatic picture. It forms a continuous wall. So such capillaries are called as continuous capillaries. In continuous capillaries, exchange of the material between the blood and the tissue takes place through the cytoplasm of the endothelial cells. This is suggested by the presence of numerous pinocytic vesicles in the cytoplasm and by the presence of numerous depressions which are known as cavioli on the cell surface, which may represent the pinocytotic vesicles in the process of formation. Apart from the transport through the cytoplasm, the substance may pass through the intercellular material separating the adjoining endothelial cells. The continuous capillaries are seen in the skin, connective tissue, muscle, lungs, and the brain. Next, we'll see about the fenestrated capillaries. In some organs, the walls of the capillaries appear to have apertures in their endothelial lining. These are therefore called as fenestrated capillaries. The apertures are, however, always closed by a thin diaphragm, which may represent greatly thinned out cytoplasm of an endothelial cells or only by the basal lamina. Some fenestration represents area where the endothelial cell cytoplasm has pores through which the entire thickness of the cell. In case of fenestrated capillaries, the diffusion of the substance takes place through the numerous fenestrae in the capillary wall. The fenestrated capillaries are seen in the renal glomeruli, intestinal villi, the endocrine glands, and the pancreas. Next, we'll see about the sinusoids. In some tissue, the exchange network is made up of vessels that are somewhat different from the capillaries, and these are called as sinusoids. Sinusoids are found typically in the organs that are made up of cords or plates of cells. So they include liver, adrenal cortex, the hypophysis cerebri, the parathyroid glands, spleen, bone marrow, and carotid body. The walls of the sinusoid consist only of the endothelium supported by a thin layer of connective tissue. The wall may be incomplete at places so that the blood may come into direct contact with the tissue cells. Deficiency in the wall may be in the form of fenestration, which are called as fenestrated sinusoids, or in the form of long slits, which are called as discontinuous sinusoids, as in the spleen. At some places, the wall of the sinusoid consists of phagocytic cells instead of endothelial cells. The sinusoids have a broader lumen, about 20 micrometer, than the capillaries. The lumen may be irregular, and because of this fact, the blood flow through them is relatively sluggish.